Hey everybody, welcome. Hey, I just wanted to give you a quick update on what's going on in a foot pain issue that I am trying to resolve before I leave for the PCT. Last summer when I did my section hike, I decided to jump on the trail runner bandwagon. So I got a pair of trail runners and I did some day hiking in them, but then I took them on a 148 mile stretch of backpacking and they did not work for me. Ultimately, I ended up in a boot. Both feet were terrible. I had a terrible case of plantar fasciitis, and I deducted that they really weren't a load-bearing shoe, so they couldn't take the weight of the pack, which maybe probably works for some people. It just didn't work for me. The other thing I noticed was that I could feel every like rock and pebble and pine cone and twig underneath my shoe, and that's not comfortable to me. There just wasn't a lot of structure to the shoe. Again, everybody's feet are different, so they work great for a lot of people. Since then, I've still been off and on battling with this. I still hike really regularly, so I'm sure I haven't helped the situation at all because I haven't really given my feet a lot of rest. I've been trying inserts. I tried another trail runner, which was the La Sportivas, and I really, really liked that shoe. But after just one hike, my feet were hurting really good in those, actually worse than they had been in a while. So I got a pair of Salomon hiking shoes just a couple of days ago, so I'm excited to try those out. I'm really hopeful for those. Again, I've done the inserts and all kinds of things. If you have experienced this and you have some suggestions, I would love to hear them. I do know that a shoe has to be able to not only go on straight stretches, but mountain terrain. The impact is going to be completely different and the shoe is going to react differently. Also, pavement versus dirt. I mean, a shoe has to be able, for each and every person, individual, a shoe has to be able to accommodate those things and react well for you, the individual. So I am not an expert. I don't know what works for everybody. It's always different. And again, if you have any suggestions for me, I would really appreciate it because I got to get this dialed in before I leave. I've only got about a month and a half left. So that's what's been going on. Also, I did get my Flash Air 1 tent in from REI the other night, and I'm excited to get that set up and kind of do a review. It seems like a pretty decent ultralight tent, but again, I want to get it set up and go through it, and I will be sharing that information with you as well. I may be swapping out my Big Agnes tent. We will see. Anyway, have a great night.